Hello and welcome to episode 44 of VocTer Gaming. I'm your host, the vocal terrorist, Jesse Rain, and we are here with the best of five series between these two players. Spawning in the east, he is our green Zerg. He is currently 2-1 up in this IEM series. He is EGIdrA. And over in the west, the blue Terran, currently 2-1 down, he is FnaticRain. Now, Rain is going to have to do something pretty nice in this game. Obviously, he needs to win the next two games to go through. IdrA here, on the other hand, just has to win this one. It's going to be really interesting to see how he goes. IdrA, of course, being the very more macro-orientated style we've seen, I imagine Rain will go for some kind of, looking on this map, with the kind of gap you have, you do have the small choke ramp there, but you do have a very large natural. There's a very wide ramp here to get up it. There are rocks here, but you can break through them. I'm expecting to see some kind of drop play from Rain. This is what I'm talking about. Either drop play or Hellions. Something that's going to do a lot of economic damage to these drones. As we see, went for the gas first, which means, of course, instant factory. Now, the 1.4 balance change is just here. That won't affect this game, but it will certainly be affecting games in the very near future, which does add 5 seconds to the barracks building time. So I wonder if gas first is necessary any longer. I wonder if you won't have the gas anyway just from building the barracks. But that'll be interesting. It's something I'm going to check a bit later when I actually get the chance to play. As we see IdrA expand down to here now. Just moving into his natural very, very quickly. I like it. It's just good play. Zergs need bases. Getting a spawning pool as well for defense. As we see the factory going down immediately, IdrA sees exactly the same thing. Obviously it means the drone does not get in, but he knows exactly what is going on in this base. And I've got to say I like that. Now, I'm pretty sure it's going to be Hellions. I think we'll be seeing Hellions at first. Potentially Blue Flame. But as we see a reactor going down here, likely we're just going to see two of each, just two Hellions. Now, I'm really not sure what IdrA is going to do to defend against that. He's got a few Lings out now. He can do a bit of scouting. He can watch, see what's going on. And as I've spoken about before, map control, very, very important. Now, if we pop back in here, we see a starport going down. That factory is now on the reactor. This barracks is getting a tech lab, which again will likely not be for the barracks considering he moved it all the way over here, but for this starport instead. So we could be seeing Hellion Banshee, which is interesting to say the least. Not sure how well that'll work. Two completely different kinds of harass. But if you have the APM, if you have the ability, I see no reason you can't do it. Hellions being minerals after all, mineral only units. So you're not having to worry about gas. Okay, these two Hellions come in. There is a spine crawler, however. Metabolic boost is going down. That's the speedling, the Zergling speed. Now these Hellions can't just dodge past this spine crawler. Obviously they can, but they will take a hit or two on the way. So right now, having to wait for backup. We now have three Hellions sat here, along with one at the Zelnaga Watchtower, just giving him a little bit of extra vision. And we have the Banshee coming out. It'll be interesting to see what timings he hits on these. Does he wait for the Banshee to go in before attacking? Pull the forces back to, say, the main, and then have the Hellions nip in and take down these? Or does he go with the Hellions first to distract from the Banshee? I think it will be very, very interesting to find out. Needs to be careful with these Ling placements here. He doesn't want them to be hit by these. gathering up a nice force for defense here, and also morphing the hatchery into the lair. I like that as well. Now there are a lot of Hellions here. Oh, but good blocking on the ramp. Keeps them in range of that spike crawler even longer. But the Banshee is here with them now. Oh, but they're just attacking the Queen. All these Hellions are going to go down. Too many Lings here as well. But there is still this Banshee out. Look at it. 5 hit points on the Banshee. 15 hit points on the Hellion. Oh, the Queen is out now. All those Hellions go down. Terrible, terrible attack from Rain. No idea what he was doing there. Managed to get his Hellions completely blocked on this ramp. And when he got them free, he just stayed here and attacked the Queen with them. Terrible, terrible move. Needs to do something big now. He's making 2 more barracks. Does have 2 Banshees though. One of which does only have 5 hit points. Should get that repaired. But 2 more barracks going down now. So it looks like he's going to try to transition into bio play. Lings here doing more damage to the Hellions. Taking them down yet again. Obviously can do nothing against this Banshee except run away. And if we pop back into the base, we see what's going down. Baneling Nest. Baneling Nest and a Spire. So we're going to see Muta Ling Bling, it looks like, from IdrA. I like that. It's something you can do a lot with it. Going to take down these rocks, going to expand to the gold base for the looks of it. It's something you can do a lot with if brain no work. If your opponent tries a harass that miserably fails like that, getting their evolution chamber and baneling speed. But 3 Banshees are out now. Now this could do a lot of damage. They could even take down the baneling nest before it finishes. Spawncrawler is going down, but it's not going to be enough. Oh, 3 Banshees takes 2 Queens very, very easily. In fact, not even 1 kill down now. This is going to be interesting. What does he do here? It needs to pull the drones. Needs to get away from there. The lair is finished. The spire is finished. He can get Mutas out. Once Mutas are out on the field, these Banshees are completely useless because they cannot fire against air. And this harassment is over now. That Banshee goes down. One last Banshee to go down. And then IdrA has complete map control right now. There is nothing right now Rain can do to stop him. Oh, Baneling's morphing over by the base here. Rain trying to expand to here. But it's not going to work because right now there is a small force of Lings and Blings down here. More Lings streaming in to join it, and the Mutas are going to join it as well. Stim is not yet finished. Stim needs to finish to give him a chance to defend against this. Only has a small force of Marines and a couple of Hellions. Now there's the 1 Medivac and the 1 Viking, but it's not going to be enough. Another barracks going down. Oh, he's lifting! He's swapping the barracks to the factory. This was terribly timed! Oh, all the Lings and the Blinks get in the base! Oh, if he can land these hits now! Oh, all the Marines going down! Oh, this is a terrible, terrible timing for Rain. IdrA is absolutely destroying him, and Rain GG's! IdrA advances in the IEM tournament, winning 3-1. What a comeback from that first game we saw. What was Rain thinking? I know he wanted to switch the barracks onto the reactor, but you do not do that when there is a force of Zerglings and Banelings right outside your base. There is a reason this is walled off. Oh, terrible timing for Rain. But well, that concludes this best of 5. IdrA wins, and I think, from the looks of it, he is definitely ready to head out to Korea again and really do a lot to challenge Code A and potentially Code S. His play in the first game was left a lot to be desired, but he definitely came back. He definitely showed his strengths in the games afterwards. So that's really good. Anyway, I will be back tomorrow. I don't have any replays selected just yet. I'm going to dig around, maybe even wait and see if we can get anything just off Battle.net with the new 1.4 changes in, so we can see how they work. But I will have a dig, I will see if there's anything going on, and of course, I will see you all tomorrow.